So welcome back students again for some special problems. Rupees 1000 was lent for 1 year, means this is the principal. Rupees 1000 at 10% per annum. So rate of interest is 10% per annum. By how much more will the interest be if the sum was and the time is 1 year only? ₹10 per annum interest being compounded half yearly. Clearly, there are two cases. In first case, there will be annual rate. So all these given quantities are used as it is. N equals to T as the interest is calculated yearly annual rate means. So 1000 into 1 plus rate of interest is 10 by 100 and clearly it will be rupees 1100. And in the second case, when the interest is reckoned half yearly, case 2, when half yearly interest will be there, number of terms in 1 year will be 2, as there will be 2 half yearly terms. This is not 2 years, 2 terms. And rate of interest will be halved, 10 by 2, that is, it will be 5% per term. In place of per annum, we will use per term. And again, now if we use the formula for amount, P into 1 plus R by 100, whole to the power n, we get 1000 into 1 plus rate of interest is 5 by 100, time is also 2 terms. In place of 2 years, it will be 2 terms. So 21 by 20 into 21 by 20, that is, 2 zeros will be cancelled out, 5 by 2 into 441. So multiply it, 5 into 441, 2 5 by 2. So it is 1102.5 rupees, means difference. We have to find what? By how much more will the interest be? So interest, difference in the interest, I have told you earlier that equals to the difference between the amounts, as principal will be cancelled out if we subtract. So there will be difference of rupees. It is 1100, na? In case of compound interest, the amount was 1100. In case of compound interest half yearly, the amount is 1102.5. So difference is only rupees 2.5. Dhai rupee is the answer. Answer is rupees 2.5. So if in question it is 10,000, then everything will be made 10 times. So the amount for first year will be 11,000 when calculated yearly rate of interest. And when half yearly rate of interest is calculated, it is rupees 11,025. So the difference will be 25 rupees. One more doubt. Amar Singh started a business with an initial investment of rupees 4 lakh. So we assume this investment as the principal of rupees 4 lakh. In the first year, he incurred a loss of 4%. So whenever there is loss, we write minus 4%. So this is the negative interest on his investment. However, during the second year, he earned a profit of 5%. So it will be positive. Profit will be taken positive. And which in the third year rose to 10%. So third year rate of interest is 10%. Calculate the net profit for the entire period of 3 years. So A equals to P into 1 plus R1 by 100 into 1 plus R2 by 100 into 1 plus R3 by 100 equals to P is 4 lakh into 1 minus rate of interest is 4 by 100 into 1 plus rate of interest is 5 by 100 into 1 plus rate of interest is 10 upon 100. So it is 4 lakh into 1 minus 100 minus 4, 96 by 100 into 100 and 5 by 100 into 100 and 10 by 100. Now if we write it again, as I have told you earlier, first write once again before intersecting, before cutting, before canceling that terms in fraction, write it once again and then start canceling. So we observe 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, all zeros will be canceled out. So now we have to only multiply 4 into 96 into 105 into 11. So 96 into 11 is 960 plus 96, 1056. Into, if you multiply 105 this is rough work only 105600 1056 into 5 is 5280. Okay, so 0 528 na 8 6 plus 2 8 5 plus 5 10 0 11 and then 96, that is 100 minus 4. So it is again 1108820 and minus 11 for the 44, 88 for the 352. 0, 352, 44, subtract it. 0, 10 minus 2, 8. 9 minus 5, 4, 7 minus 3, 4, 8 minus 4, 4, 10 minus 4, 6, 10 rupees is the final answer. First we have multiplied 96 into 11. Are it is taken twice. 96 into 11 into 105 was already done. Wait. This is the extra thing. Now we have to do only 4 times. Five plus five, 10 into 4. This is the final sum. Four lakh 43,520 is net profit. So how will you calculate net profit? Net profit means final worth. 4,43,520 means initial investment of the company, that is rupees 43,520, which will be the answer. So if you use the tricks as I have discussed, it will be easy to calculate. Hope you must have understood this method also.